Good morning, Steve Free in Chicago with the morning grain comments. Well, overnight prices are a little bit higher. Yesterday we had a pretty steep sell-off, especially when forecasters put more rain in the dry areas of central Brazil next week. Those rains are still in the forecast, but I think the key right now is what's the weather over the next 30 days in South America? This week it's going to be warm and dry across most of Argentina and Brazil. One crop scout lowered the Brazil soybean crop 2 million tons to 130 versus the USDA's 133, and lowered the full season corn crop down 2 million tons at 104 versus the USDA's 110. Their Argentina soybean crop is 49 versus the USDA's 51, and the Argentina corn crop is 48 versus the government's 50. Basically, somewhere between 30 and 50% of the Brazil and Argentina corn and soybean crops are stressed right now due to the dryness. Rain should pop up next week, and I think over the next 30 days you should see more of a normal forecast for the central north Brazil, but La Nina could bring in dryness in southern Brazil and eastern Argentina. We also note that there should be a record October crush U.S. today at 196.6 versus 187.2 last year. USDA raised the winter wheat crop ratings here to 46% good to excellent, despite the fact that the U.S. Southern Plains was dry and should remain dry and warm over the next 30 days. European wheat exports only 9 million tons, down 24% from last year. And it's interesting that hard wheat now in the U.S. is below the French and German price and only a dollar above Russia. Matif, though, wheat futures yesterday, three-week lows. Australia wheat futures at 13-week lows. Funds yesterday sold 17,000 beans, 27,000 corn, and 13,000 wheat. Still long about 200,000 beans, 70 meal, 100 oil, probably around 280, 285 corn, and only 15 wheat. Outside market stocks are higher, dollars a little bit lower, crude's about unchanged, gold and copper is higher, and copper's making new highs. The talk about the vaccine, I think, is supporting the marketplace. We do note that OECD lowered their estimate of the U.S. 2021 economic growth to 3% from 4%, and the Eurozone to 3.6% from 5%. They continue to show growth in China, better than the rest of the world at 8% growth. That could help China's demand for energy, it could help China's demand for raw materials, and for base metals. As always, these are my thoughts, not those of ADM or ADM Investor Services. Have a safe and profitable trading day. Remember, always treat people like you yourself would like to be treated.